So this is my, since I do the alternative medicine talk a lot, I get asked about this. So here's a little patient who says, doctor, you know, I've lost faith in Western medicine. And it's an interesting way to start, because in fact, most patients who come to do complementary medicine have not lost faith in Western medicine. They don't want an either-or solution. They want a both-and solution. Supplement use, for example, is high in all phases of cancer care, and even in women who are at high risk. It use increases after diagnosis, even if you're in the hospital, even during phase one trials, radiation, etc. And I would say for lots of cancer cases where patients feel at risk, it's even higher. So when you decide whether to do something, you're going to be making this calculation in your head. What's the risk of taking the therapy? We look at risk first, because if something's not safe, that makes us less likely to take it. What's the potential for benefit? And then what's the cost? We count in cost here, not just money, but other kinds of costs, and so should you. One of the costs may be, what if this interferes with your conventional treatment? So the idea is that we want to give you maximum benefit from the complementary side while not interfering with the conventional treatment. And if you're thinking about doing a complementary therapy and you hear these things, then your antenna should go up and you should be more suspicious. Unfortunately, the label doesn't always tell you enough to make a clear choice. So what I say is a good label doesn't guarantee a good product, but a bad label is a big warning sign. Okay, so the dietary supplement label, especially an herbal label, will look like this. So it tells you the exact amount, and then you see here how it says it's echinacea extract. Then the next thing it tells you is these two words together that look like Latin, echinacea purpurea. This is the botanical name of the plant. All plants, like you have a first and a last name, plants have a first and a last name, and it should be on the label. It tells you what's in it, and then there should be a lot number, which tells you when it was manufactured and expiration date. So these are the major attributes you should look for. Now, if you're gonna have a good, healthy diet, this is what the anti-cancer plate looks like from Dr. Servan Schreiber's new book, Anti-Cancer, A New Way of Life. For patients who are going through active treatment, nobody eats enough protein. Everybody who comes to see me has to eat more protein. Almost nobody eats enough protein. And this is a time when your body's under a lot of stress from the chemo, and it tears down the tumor, but it also stresses what we call your lean tissue. So we really want you to keep your lean tissue going, eat well, and eat to be strong. Lots of food agents are being actively investigated for their use as chemo preventive agents. So garlic, and we're going to talk a little about turmeric curcumin. It's very interesting for pancreatic cancer patients. Pomegranates, the propolis from honeybees, aloes, soybeans, all these kind of things are being investigated. So the good news is that including foods that are rich in these phytochemicals will provide you these chemicals in the way that nature intended. So that's why we tell you to eat a variety of foods if you're able, and eat foods that are brightly colored. In general, given the option, patients say to me, well, how much beta carotene do I need to take in a pill? And I'm like, well, how many carrots do you eat? Start with what you're able to eat. Do that first. So if you can get that, you not only get the beta carotene, you get fiber, you get other carotenoids, etc. But we do go for some things in the supplement form. So here's my vitamin D spiel. So there is a huge, huge deficiency of vitamin D in this population, and I think it does increase risk for a lot of cancers. There's a big debate going on now about how much vitamin D you should take. I think your 1,000 is the entry level. I think for me, with worrying about cancer, 2,000 is the entry level, because it takes about 1,700 international units in the average patient to get to the bottom of the normal range. And that level is sufficient to protect bone. But I think a higher level is required to actually manage cancer risk. And you need to be replete in vitamin D to have a functional immune system. But I think that there was one clinical trial that really drives my advice, and it was people were given 2,000 international units of vitamin D a day, or not, enough calcium, and then they looked at people over 3 years. The group that got 2,000 international units of vitamin D a day had 50% less cancer develop in that 3 years. I want to talk a little bit about turmeric. That's the name. So turmeric is the spice that gives curry its yellow color. So a good curcumin extract is going to be a nice bright yellow. If it's kind of a dirty brown, it may not be a good product. There are stages that a cancer has to go through before it becomes a big problem. In each of these places, there are actions that turmeric has been shown to have in test tubes against pancreatic cancer cells. So not only does it have, it's a very strong anti-inflammatory, this again is an interesting plant to think about developing as an adjunctive therapy for cancer. So set appropriate goals. Pick good quality supplements in concert with someone to give you good advice. I like to look at simpler rather than more complicated formulas. Interaction is something I'm always checking for. And if I'm worried about it, then I tend to pick non-herbal supplements. So even though I think interactions are not common, they're more likely to happen with an herb. Know that a lot of these things can come in chewable forms or liquid forms as swallowing pills becomes a problem. Disclose your use to the medical team, and if necessary, educate them. I do think that the process of going through this, you can make yourself feel better, you can make the chemo less toxic, you can survive your surgery better, you can eat more wisely, and maintain your energy. Thank you very much for inviting me today. I really appreciate it.